Hey, it's David Baer here from Baer on Marketing. In today's video, we're going to be looking at 9 very common mistakes that a lot of business owners, entrepreneurs out there are making when it comes to creating and marketing webinars. One of the big mistakes that a lot of my clients actually run into is having a fear of running into mistakes, and that is what keeps them back from planning and hosting their webinars. So hopefully the information in this video is really going to help you. Because ultimately, webinars are an excellent way to get qualified leads, build your expertise and your authority in your field, and to develop buzz around you, your business, your products, and your services. So let's dive in. Mistake number one is not practicing in advance of your webinar. It's important to practice your presentation as well as things like handing off the mic and the controls to co-presenters who might also be participating. And understanding how everything works before the big event is going to make everything go a lot more smoothly. Okay, mistake number two, a lack of preparation. So in addition to practicing, it's important to prepare for your event. Make sure that your microphone works, ensure that you have a quiet space to record or to present your event. Get your presentation ready and study up on all the questions that might potentially come up during your webinar so that you are in a position to answer them as thoroughly and with as much authority as possible. Okay, mistake number three, not setting up landing pages. So when you're actually serious about selling something or providing information about anything, it's important that you take the time to set up a systemized way to sell, to capture information. And so sales pages, landing pages are incredibly important. And very often, I find that my clients start the webinar process but don't actually have a ready-made page to send people to when it comes time for their call to action. It's really, really important because it's the best way to get more conversions in sales webinars in particular. Okay, next, skimping on professional assistance. Now, I've mentioned a few times that I have clients, but listen, you can't do everything yourself all the time. And so engaging a professional out there who can help you makes a lot of sense. Sometimes you're good at one aspect of the webinar, but not others. So why not outsource some of the responsibilities, some of the technical things, some of the preparation things to others so that you can focus on what you know best? All right, let's move on. Setting too broad of a topic. Now, this goes to any presentation, but webinars in particular, because as you're trying to drive traffic, you want to target specific people around a specific topic. So what you want to do is narrow down your topic to a very specific, very tight, small area, because you don't want to overwhelm your listeners. Basically, the viewers who are going to, you know, show up, shut down their Facebook, shut down everything else, and focus on what you're delivering, you don't want to be throwing too much information at them at once. Plus, a narrow topic is easier for you to market, and you can be more assured of attracting that very specific tight audience who you want to show up. All right, let's move on. Not understanding what your audience needs. Now, this is a really big one, because your job is to solve your customers' or your prospects' problems, and you can't do that if you don't know what they actually need. You can't do that if you don't know who they are specifically, what their roles are, what the challenges are that they're dealing with in their personal or professional life, however your business might address their needs. So when you focus on problem solving, you're going to come up with a better topic overall. All right, next mistake is failing to market your webinar. Now, this is a huge one because you can do a webinar, but if you don't actually tell people about it effectively, well, chances of having a successful webinar are pretty, pretty small. So there's no such thing as a build it and they will come webinar experience. You really need to do something to get the word out, whether it's social media, blog posts, articles, guest articles, advertising, a blog tour, whatever else you can do to get the word out. You want to make sure that you have a strategy not only for the content of the webinar, but also getting people over to the webinar. All right, next mistake is forgetting to test out your technology. Now, technology is a big part of webinars. And even though issues happen, right, you're always going to run into something. If you have tested it in advance, the likelihood is it's a lot smaller. So the more tests that you conduct, the more comfortable you feel in the technological environment of doing a webinar, the more smoothly things are going to go. You cannot ever know this for sure, of course, but testing is really going to help make you a lot more comfortable. Finally, not having a webinar to begin with. Now, that's a huge mistake. It's possibly the biggest mistake there is because webinars are incredibly powerful. But listen, once you've done a webinars one or two or three times, you're going to get hooked on this. They can be as small and as cozy or as large as you want them to be. You just have to do them with frequency and more consistency that you engage with webinars, the better you're going to get at it. So look, you're going to make mistakes sometimes. Everybody does, but there's no reason to reinvent the wheel when it comes to webinars. Someone has had a webinar before you, and there are going to be people who will have webinars again after you. Just find the webinar that's going to be best for you and start creating your webinars today.